أهلا بكم مشاهدينا، وهذه هي حلقة جديدة مع برنامجنا MMA ALL OUT. أحب أرحب بمعلقنا دكتور ريو. علي مش هيكون معانا النهاردة لأنه عنده مهمة خارجية، بس مشرفنا في الاستوديو كابتن رأفت.
رأفت شاوي. رأفت شاوي طبعا أحب أقدم بطل العراق وبطل دولي، بدايته كانت بالكاراتيه، معروف في MMA، مؤخرا شارك في عدة بطولات DFC ADFC Desert Force أو كتشالا كويست، فمعروف عنه. حابب ارحب بك.
شكرا رأفت. شكرا للاستضافه.
زي ما عودتونا عودتوا السادة المشاهدين، لو تديني بس فكره سريعه عن المباراه اللي معانا في حلقه
المباراه الجايه راح تكون بين انيس دادا اللي هو 93 حوالي
خفيف الثقيل
ووتر ويت، فايز مباراه واحده فقط، وراح يكون مع سكوت تورنر. اول مره راح يكون
الديبيو، صح؟
راح الديبيو مات، ما اعرف، انا اعتقد سكات يتكلمون عنه لمنطقته انه قوته الجسمانيه اقوى. لما تشوفين راح تشوفين انه انيس دادا شويه الجسم مو بذاك، يعني شوفين ما شاء الله كابتن رافت اي يعني جسمه يتكلم. انيس دادا تلاحظين انه في كنفلاب، لما تكون واحد كنت كبطل او راح تروح الى MMA فايت لازم يكون جسمك يناسب المقاتل، تكون مستعد. هذا الشيء لاحظت لما قاعد يدخلون، لاحظت الشيء بسيط انه الجسم
يبين استعداد
اللاعب اكثر، بس تلاحظ انه يعني ما نقدر نحكم على الفيديو القتال المختلف، ممكن يصير فيها اي شيء.
شكرا لكم شباب، خلينا نطلع نشوف الجوله الاولى ونشوف ايه اللي هيحصل فيها.
Scott definitely the bigger of the two, more powerful. But we mentioned earlier the one thing in Anish's favor is he's done this before. Even though it's only the once, he knows what it's like there. And this is the first time for Scott Turner. But as you said, we don't know how many Muay Thai fights he might have had.
And he goes for the shot. That's what's so great about MMA. You know, a fighter coming from a Muay Thai gym looking for a takedown.
Oh, the amount of times, as you know, Luke, because obviously with the commentaries, you've done them yourself. You've been on the other side in big, big shows. You set a fight up for something and it goes totally the opposite way.
I mean, but that happens too in camps and with training. You know, you could be training for a fighter and think he's going to do one thing, and he does the complete opposite. So the way I try and always think is I think about what I'm going to do, how I'm going to do it, and you know, and I try and implement that.
And when you talk about what you're going to do, Anish Dada has reversed this nicely, because it was Scott Turner went for the takedown, but he's the man in the bottom position now. Very slick from Dada, wasn't it?
Yeah, he you know, he used the momentum there from Scott, and he's really turned it around and got into this half guard position on top. Again, can't land the shots to the head, so he's looking to land body shots.
Now, when we talk about that, because obviously for safety they can't do the ground and pound yet, it's important for the judges to see a level of control then, isn't it, there? And I don't mean control as in controlling shots, as in controlling the person. And that's what Anish did there very well, didn't he? Okay, so he can't land to the head, but he's saying, look, I'm in control of this situation, as he's got his back now.
He's got the one hook on the right side. And Scott's trying to turn out and get back into his guard, which I think he's going to be successful in doing, and he does. You know, great vision there from Scott to see stacking him up. And you can really get some power in these body shots now.
Yes, the right hand pistoned out twice to the rib cage of Anish, but has he got the arm? Has Anish got, he's looking for the arm.
He's got a mixture of an armbar and a triangle here, but gets shucked straight off. A very active fight on the ground here from these Muay Thai fighters that we thought we were going to see.
That's right.
We talk about control, it's completely shifted now.
Yes.
Scott taking the back here of Anish.
And this is what I was saying about the level of semi-professional fights we've seen tonight. Excellent value for money, real slick transitions, all-round skills. And he's got the guillotine, has Scott Turner, but he hasn't really been able to...
Oh. And a takedown, but has he fallen deep into that guillotine?
Well, that was my worry for him, because Scott didn't really have it on deeply, but when Anish took him down, there's always the worry, and we see it a lot at semi-pro level, that you actually make it worse for yourself. It hasn't happened here to Anish Dada, but I've seen it so many times.
I mean, the thing with that is, on the takedown attempt, a lot of people do go to grab the head and look for that guillotine, because it's quite it's quite an easy technique to pull off. But it's the complete wrong thing you want to do when you're trying to stop someone from taking you down. Beautiful transition there from Scott, coming out the back door and really landing heavy. This guy throws the lever like, you know, like someone who's had a lot of fights. See here how he's grabbing rounds. His whole body in his head. He has no real control here. He wants to try and get an underhook, pull his opponent up, or push his head down to stop the drive with one of the arms. When he just grabs round his whole body, he's just clinging on to Dada, and if Dada wants, he can lift and get a take, which he's going to get.
Yes, but this will gain, you mentioned the experience. Now, it's been brought to our attention that alongside the Muay Thai, Scott Turner is a black belt judoka, which might make more sense of the way those transitions and the way he moved there.
He's definitely got a bit of a ground game, and he's looking for the takedown.
Oh, big right hand, though, rocks Dada suddenly, and the right uppercut. Dada's legs have gone. This is overloop.
And there we go from a beautiful transition on the ground to a judoka to a knockout ice, and he gets the finish.
You said early in the fight you felt he had power. He showed it there, the right hand, then the right uppercut, then the third right, and it was all over. And Anish Dada looked shocked. He was in that fight right to the moment those three blistering punches landed.
Oh, definitely that uppercut was the one that did it for me. A beautiful change of shape, going up the middle and catching with that uppercut, shocked Dada, and then he just followed up very, very well. Killer instinct there from him as well. He's almost got the mirror image a little bit of a Buswick, you know, the size and the haircut.
But explosive finish from Scott Turner.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a winner by 3 minutes, 44 seconds in the very first round. By way of KO, please put your hands together for the fighter out of the blue corner, Scott Turner!
Impressed me most.
We'll take a brief look at some of the highlights from future and previous UWC.
أنا شايفة إن الملاكمة والبوكسينج أو الكيك بوكسينج هي اللي حسمت الموقف مش الجيجيتسو صح؟
صح هي كانت سترايكس يعني كانت ما راحوا للأرض كثير لا تنسين هم الباك جراوند مالتهم واحد موي تاي جيم يدرسوا الموي تاي والثاني اسمه ستوب كيك فمن اسمه تعرف إنه كمان سترايكينج فما فيها جرابلينج على الأرض
هم بدوا المشكلة إنه هم لما بدوا الفايت بدوها حاولوا ياخذوها على الأرض وما على العلم هم اثنيناتهم سترايكرز
أنا هذا اللي ما فهمه لما أنت تكون سترايكر وتكون أنت متعود على كيك بوكسينج وبوكسينج ليش تحاول تحول على أنا أعرف إنه هي جزء من اللعبة بالكامل
ممكن
المفروض الواحد يركز على المهارات مالتك أنت الباك جراوند مالتك كاراتيك كيك بوكسينج بوكسينج المفروض تركز عليها ما تأخذ على الأرض هسه ممكن تتعلم الجرابلينج في حالة المباراة راحت على الأرض بس أعتقد المفروض كان ملا ولا يركز
مرات يحاول اللاعب إنه يفاجئ خصمه يعني يخليه يعتقد إنه راح يوقف وياه ويسوي كيك بوكسينج فيحاول يفاجئ إنه يأخذ على
انت صورت الحكم خلصها مباشره
لا بالعكس انا اشوف انه الحكم خلصها بالوقت المناسب وحمال اللاعب الثاني لانه شاف انه اللاعب الثاني خلاص انتهى وما يقدر يدافع عن نفسه فما راد يعرض الاذيه اضافيه صح. فحسمها بالوقت المناسب
صح يعني زاد كان مبين عليه قلت لك ما كان مستعد ما تشوف فيه اللياقه كانت
ما كان يعني شوف جسمه يعني ما كان متكن وما كان متهيئ للمباراه بصوره صحيحه مضبوط
طبعا رأفتي عجبه يكون الانسان مصقول صقل
شكرا لكم مشاهدينا على حسن متابعتنا وان شاء الله الحلقه تكون عجبتكم انا جوري بكر وبتمنى لكم سهره سعيده مع بقيه برامج فيزيك تي في ولكل المعلومات زوروا موقعنا الالكتروني وللتواصل معنا عندكم صفحات الفيسبوك وتويتر ودلوقتي اقول لكم باي